Okay, so hello. So I recall you that last time we defined operator invariant of tangles using some solution of the Young-Baxter equation. So the question is how to obtain such solutions. So we will obtain this solution using the quantum groups, representation of quantum groups. And to define quantum group, we need the notion of off-algebra. So, and today, I will define what are off-algebras. OK. Maybe I quickly recall what are algebras. OK. I recall that an algebra we work over a field K. What is it? It is a vector space A, which is endowed with two linear maps. So the product with, sorry, I should say linear maps, M from the tensor product of A to A, and we call this the product. The product. And another linear map from K, the ground field to A, the unit. And this map should be, so the product is associative with unit U. Okay, as we have seen. So if I denote the product like this, from A tensor A to A, and the unit like this, from K to A, so associative means we have this. And U is a unit means that we have this. And maybe a map from K to A, a linear map from K to A, is just characterized by the unit, the image of the unit of K. So, sometimes I will use the unit element of A is one, the image of, okay. So maybe I recall that an algebra homomorphism between two algebras A and B is a k-linear map such that, so it preserves the product and send the unit element to the unit element. For all and in graphical notation, so what is it? So F is a map, the image of the product, so A B is a product of the image. A, B. So this action graphically is this one, and the image of the unit element means is a unit element. Okay. Maybe I should give some example. First example of a K-algebra. K itself is a K-algebra with its product and its unit. Maybe I should say that if X, I consider a set X. And I denote by f of x is a set, the set of maps from x to k. Donc, so clearly f of x is a vector space, but it is f of x is a K algebra. So with product so defined by, so if you take two functions from x to k, you want to define the function, the product, so it's just the product of their value. Well, and unit element, one defined by x is just the constant function equal to. So this is another example of an K algebra. Let's see now. If I have, let's see another example. Now I can consider that X be a monoid. So what is a monoid? Just a set which is endowed with an associative product which has a unit. So it's like a group, but without the assumption that every element is as an inverse. Okay, now, so we can consider K of X is K vector space which has by this the set X. So then it is a K algebra with product, so the product is a map like this, and unit so defined by M. If I take two elements of the basis, it's just their product. We can multiply element of X because it is a monoid. And U of K is just the unit of X. And the axiom, the fact that the product of the monoid is associative implies that the product of this algebra is associative, etc. Okay, let's see other examples. Maybe this one. If I take V, I take a vector space V, then I can consider the set of linear endomorphisms of V, which produce the composition and unit element, the identity, is the K algebra. It's an algebra. This is an algebra. And finally, maybe. So I can say that if the tensor product of two algebras is again an algebra, so if A and B are algebras, then that tensor product so with product so the product of M tensor B is defined as the tensor product of A and B composed with identity of A to A identity of B, and the unit of A tensor B is U of A. And here, as usual, here, tau BA is just a fit map between B and A. B and A. B. Is the flip. So graphically, mu A tensor B. So I recall the flip. We can denote it like this. From B tensor A to A tensor B. So the product in A tensor B is like this. So you have A, B, A, B. What do you do? You flip first, take the product. And the unit okay now maybe I recall that so I pick a an algebra A. So what is the A module? Let's consider left A module. Or we say also representation of A. It is a vector space A, so a vector, let's call it M, which is endowed with a linear map R from A tensor M to M, which we call the action. Which should satisfy the following properties. So first, AB times m is just a times bm, and the unit of a times m is m. For all a, b in the algebra and m in m. And here, what means the notation? AM is just the image by the action of A tensor M. Okay, so this is the left action. And graphically, so what means this action? So I can take first R from A tensor M to M. Can take again R. So I first take here the product from A tensor A to A. Then I take the action. So means that I can take, what can I do else? Take twice the action. And the other product is just that if I apply the unit to the action, it does not change. So this are the axiom of an action. Okay. Let me make a remark. So a linear map from A tensor M to M is an action. So satisfies the condition. If and only if the map rho from M to the from A to the endomorphism of M. So the endomorphism of the vector space is an algebra. So here we have a map from an algebra. So A maps to or A just M, the M, M to M. So is an algebra homomorphism. So this is the same thing. And I will need the notion of a morphism or homomorphism of A modules. Between A modules M and N, it should be a linear map which preserves the action. So it's a linear map such that, so we say that, so I should say, K. So linear map here, K linear for the field. And we require that this linear map is A linear. And what I mean by this, that it is compatible with the actions. So F of AM is A F of M. For all A in A, M in M. And graphically, what does it mean? That we have a map from M to N. So I can first take the action R of M. This is the same that, say, N, N, A, F. And here, where R is the action of M, and S is the action of A. Okay, graphically, we have this condition. Maybe I make a remark. And then I say that if I have M and N are A modules, if I take two A modules M and N, then their tensor product, what is it in general? It is an, if I have an algebra, we have seen that the tensor product of two algebras is an algebra. So we can take is a tensor product of A with A, and we obtain A tensor A module with action. Sure. So if I take A tensor A prime M tensor N is A M. So A prime N for all A prime A prime M. Okay. But in general, the tensor product M tensor S is not an A module. So we would like to have extra condition on the algebra A so that for any module M and N, their any A module M and N, their tensor product is again an A module. And to have this condition leads to the notion of bi-algebra. Maybe I recall, we have seen this, that a coalgebra is, over a field K, is a vector space C. Which is endowed with a coproduct and co-unit. With linear maps from C to C tensor C. Is the coproduct and epsilon C, okay, is the co-unit such that so the coproduct is co-associative and with co-unit epsilon. So and And here I denote delta like this, si, si tensor C, and epsilon, the coordinate, from C to 1 like this. This is this. You just reverse the axiom of an algebra. It is an algebra in the category, opposite category of vector space, if you know. Okay. So now, what is an algebra? A bi-algebra. Bi-algebra. Well, field K is a vector space A, which is endowed with four linear maps so from A tensor A to A multi-product, as you can imagine. We have a unit from K to A. A co-product from A to A tensor A. And a co-unit from A to K. The co-unit such that we have these following actions. So first action, as you can imagine, with a name that A, if I M U is an algebra. Second action is that A with delta and epsilon, it is a coalgebra. And the third action so I recall that so A is an algebra. That thus, A tensor A is again an algebra. And also, we know that K is an algebra. So, and we require that delta and epsilon are algebra homomorphisms. Homomorphisms. So in graphical notation, so if you traduce what are the product here and here, it means that so the delta preserves the unit, the coproduct is multiplicative, so take this is twice the coproduct and the product of A tensor A, which is this. So the coproduct should preserve the unit. Now, the co-unit is multiplicative means, so this is, and so this is one of K. So this is a condition for delta epsilon to be homomorphism of algebras. Maybe I make a remark. So this is different from the notion of Frobenius algebra. That we have seen in chapter one. Where the condition three is replaced by the Frobenius relation by... Now, the coproduct is not multiplicative, but should satisfy the Frobenius relation like this. Okay, so you do not... So this is a different notion from that of a Frobenius relation. So let's see some examples. Maybe. So. Example. So first, K itself is a bi-algebra. With coproduct, we know that K is already an algebra, but with coproduct delta from K to K tensor K, co-unit epsilon from K to K. So defined by so the image, we have no choice. Delta should be an isomorphism. A morphism of algebra, so it sends the unit to the unit. And this defines epsilon, delta, and again for epsilon. Okay, so this is a trivial example. Now, consider a monoid X. We have seen that the free vector space with basis X is an algebra. So we can consider the algebra K of X is a bi-algebra. With coproduct so delta from K of X to K of X and co-unit epsilon from K of X to K defined by so delta of X is just X. So X and epsilon of X is 1. For X in X. Okay. So this defines linear map. And you can verify the axiom of bi-algebra. So let us verify one of the axiom that the coproduct is indeed multiplicative.
Sorry, how epsilon can be higher?
Sorry?
I don't understand it. If you take epsilon of x plus x, it should be TK, right? Mm. Or do you...
No. X plus x is not an element of, of the basis. No, it just defined on the basis element. And you extend this by linearity, OK? So let us quickly verify that we have this axiom. And we should be equal to this. So we only need to verify this on a basis element. So I take x and y in x. So here I put x, and here I put y. So let's say, so as usual, so here x tensor y is sent by definition of the product, it is sent to x, y, but x, y is an element of x because x is a monoid, so its coproduct is given by x, y, so x, y. So now we look here. So if I take x tensor y, I take twice the coproduct. So the coproduct of x is x tensor x, then y tensor y. Now I exchange the two central elements, so x and y here. So I get x tensor y tensor x tensor y. And then I take the product. XY tensor XY. And you can see that these maps are the same maps. So this means that the delta defined like this is indeed multiplicative. And you can verify easily the other actions. Okay, so let us see another example. Let us consider now a finite monoid. A monoid which is finite as a set. So, and we can consider the algebra of function of x on x. Of p-valued function on x. We have seen this example before. So, the product of x induces a collinear map. Let's call it delta from f of x to what? To f of x times x. F maps to. So how can I define a map of on from x times x to k? XY maps to. I have a product in x, so I take. I can evaluate f on the product x and y. Okay. So this is always defined, even when x is not finite. But why do we assume that x is finite? Since x is finite, the linear map let's call it from f of x, also f of x to f of x times x. If I take two k-value function on x, f and j, I can already define a function like this, so f tensor g, so x times x to k, to k, so now x, y I can set to the I evaluate x with f and y with g. So f with x and g with y. So take the product. So you can verify that this map is K-linear. But when x is finite, this map is an isomorphism. You can easily show this. So then the function of x is a bi-algebra. So you want to go from f of x to f of x times f of x. So you take phi inverse and co-unit. To k define epsilon of f, you evaluate f as the unit. Okay, and you can verify that it is indeed a bi-algebra. And before the break, let us see last example. Now I take V, a vector space. So I can consider the tensor algebra, so how it is defined. So if I have an integer k, I denote tk. Of V is I take the tensor product of V with itself k times. And the empty tensor product is just the grand phi, so you have T0 of V is just k, T1 of V is V, T2 of V just V tensor V, etc. And we set, so what is the tensor algebra? Is the direct sum as a vector space, it is a direct sum of the TK. So, and now with the product M from T to V and unit from K to T of V, how are they defined? Right, so if I take x an element of tk of v and y an element of tl of v, so their product so I would denote like this, the product is you just take which is in Tk plus L of V. And the unit element, just the unit of K, which is in T0 of V. Of course, this is inside T of V. So this is an algebra called the tensor algebra. And Do you know what is the universal property of this algebra? Should you never seen this algebra before? No? So what is the universal property is the following. So T of V satisfies the following universal property. What has been universal property? It is a property which characterizes the tensor algebra, of course, up to isomorphism. So for all linear map F from V to A, where A is an algebra over K, of course. If I take a linear map from the vector space V to an algebra, it extends uniquely. So I should say any linear maps extends uniquely to an algebra homomorphism T of F from the tensor algebra to A. How do you construct this? It is quite clear. If you take x1, x, v1, let's say, v1, v, vk in v, it is defined by f of v1, f of the image of, you can multiply element in the image of f, so f v1, f vk for v1. Vk in V. So this is an extension. You can show it is unique. It's quite clear, in fact. And now, and I finish with this. If I consider so the linear map. So from V to T of V, tensor T of V, V maps to V tensor 1 plus 1 tensor V. And V to K, V maps to 0, so extends. They extend to maps to algebra homomorphism. Delta and epsilon. And the tensor algebra is a bi-algebra with a coproduct delta and co-unit epsilon. I leave you as an exercise to verify that it is indeed a bi-algebra. Okay. Okay, maybe we make the break. And after the break, I will define the off algebras. Okay, so we have defined the notion of bi-algebra. I gave examples. Now, bi-algebras, a key feature of bi-algebras is that the tensor product of representations. Is a representation. So more precisely, if M and N are modules over by algebra A, then M tensor N is a module, is a name module, is again. And how is defined the action? Alors, let's call it T. So you need to define for the action from A, tensor N, tensor N. What you do is you take the coproduct of A, go to A tensor A, you take the action A of M, of the first component, and then the action S of N. And you end up with A tensor N to M tensor N. And here, A is the action of M. Of M and S is the action of it. So we need to verify that it is indeed an action. How do we verify this? So first axiom, so if we plug the unit, what happens? We plug the unit, now the coproduct is an algebra morphism, so its image of the unit is a unit of A tensor A, that this is this, R, S, N, M, N, N, so this is. Here we use the naturality of the flip maps. And this is just which is identity of M tensor N. Okay. By the action of a module, we have this equality. Okay, so this is the first action. Let us quickly check the other action. So we have T of identity of A O times T. So what is it? It is, so, then again, I take S, okay, by definitions. So now, again, I use the naturality of the flip maps. So I have this S. Okay. Now I can use the fact that R and S are action of A. So what happens? This is, so here we have take the product and R. Take the product and S. Again, I use the naturality of the flip maps, and I end with something like this. And finally, we have the fact that the coproduct is an algebra homomorphism implies that this is just this S. And this is indeed what we want, T M tensor identity of M tensor M. Okay. So here I have verified that the tensor product of two A modules is an A module. So that's one of the main properties of bi-algebra. And also, what do we have? We have that K is an A module. With action. So what is action on A on K? So this is isomorphic to A. It is induced by the co-unit. So K has a natural structure of an A module via the co-unit. And the property is the following. So for any A modules M and P, the standard K-linear isomorphisms, we know as vector space, we know that V, if I multiply V with a ground field, does not change. K tensor V, so we have natural isomorphism like this, and also, it is M. And also, if I take three vector space, M and N, either I can take the tensor product, first the tensor product of M with N and then with P, or first N and P and then with M. So we have K-linear isomorphism, the usual one. So in fact, this are isomorphism of A modules. This means that they are not only K-linear, but they are A-linear. And I leave you this, this property as an exercise. And maybe, okay, so what should I say? No, I will introduce off algebras. So I do not remember the number of this section. I think it's three. Okay. So maybe I call it if G is a monoid, if you have a monoid, then the algebra of this monoid is a bi-algebra. We have seen this. Now, if you assume that G is a group, what is the extra structure What is the extra structure on this bi-algebra? So a difference between the monoin and the group is that each element has an inverse. So we have the inversion map. So the inversion map. Inversion of G, it induces this map, a k-linear map. Let's call it S from K of G to K of G. And it is defined on the basis element. S of G is G inverse. Now, what is the property satisfied by S, this map S? So, we have this action on the group G. So, we should express both sides of this equality using the structure maps of the bi-algebra and S. So, G. This is for G in G. So this action, G inverse, how do we express using the product, coproduct, antipode, and the map S? So it is M, the product of G times G inverse. It is M, G times F, S of G. This is M identity of KG times S of G times G. Plus G times G is the coproduct of G. So it is M identity times S delta of G. And similarly, G inverse G is S is in the order. Now, how can we compute one? One is one epsilon g, because epsilon g is one, u epsilon of g. Okay. Thus, we obtain that M identity S delta is U epsilon is M S identity delta. So in this example, the fact that the elements of G as inverse traduces with these equalities. And we take this as a definition of an antipode. So an antipode of bi-algebra A is what? Is a map, is a linear map S from A to A such that M S as identity of A delta is U epsilon is M identity of A. Okay, that's the definition. Let me make a remark. So if you have an algebra A, if if you have an algebra A, and C is a coalgebra, then the set of k-linear maps I will denote by conv CA. This is a set of k-linear maps from C to A. It is again an algebra. With convolution, the product with product called convolution, defined by if I take f and g two maps from C to A, what can I do? I can take the coproduct. I can take f and g. I end up with A. And then take the product. This is the product of A, F tensor G, times the coproduct of C. And this product is called the convolution product. And you need it is U of A epsilon of C. And you can verify that the co-associativity of the coproduct of C and the associativity of the product of A implies that it is indeed an algebra. So in particular, we have that if A is a bi-algebra, then we can consider the convolution algebra from A to A, because A is both coalgebra and an algebra. And if you see the definition of an antipod, you see that of algebra A is a linear map such that this axiom means that S is a convolution algebra, the product of S and the identity is the unit is an entity of A. So this is in the convolution algebra from A. This means what? That S, that is an inverse of the identity of A in the convolution algebra. And if an element is invertible in an algebra, of course, its inverse is unique. Thus, an antipod of A if it exists, an antipod of A is unique. You can, a bi-algebra cannot have two antipodes because an inverse of an element is always unique. And we say that an off-algebra It is a bi-algebra. Having an antipode. That's the definition of algebra. And so we can show you several properties of the antipode. And in particular, that an antipode is anti-multiplicative and anti-commutative. So we say that we have that the antipode S of of algebra A is anti multiplicative. This means that S notation, so S of AB is S of B, S of A, and S of 1 is 1. In graphical notation, what does it mean if I take S, S, the product, so this is okay, so it is anti-multiplicative and anti-commutative. So this is in graphical notation. So if I take S and the coproduct, the same as S. So the, first the coproduct, S, S, and like this. And S with the co-unit is just the co-unit. Okay. Okay. Maybe I just show one of these equalities. How can we show such properties? It's via the convolution algebras. So, set form, we prove the first equality here. So set, let's say F is S M from A tensor A to A, and G is M S tensor S to AA from A tensor A to A. And we need to prove that F is equal to G. So we have that A tensor A is a coalgebra with coproduct so you take the coproduct of A and you insert the flip co-unit, the co-unit of A tensor A, just the tensor product of the co-unit. Okay. So like the tensor product of two algebras is an algebra, the tensor product of two co-algebras is a co-algebra. And we can consider the convolution algebra from this coalgebra A to the algebra A. A tensor A to the algebra A. If no. Now we compute. We can compute the convolution product of F with M. By definition, what is it? It is, so, S, M with M. So you take the coproduct as a product. Now this is an action of a B algebra, so this is S like this. Now this condition it is, so by the definition of an antipode, this is just the coordinate with the unit, and so it is the unit of this convolution algebra. And again, we have the tensor M. So now we have G, this other map, so we take first the product S, this, or the product, this one, by definition. Now using the associativity here of the product, what do I get? I get S, so here I can take the product first here. And here, like this. Okay. So I use here the fact that the product is associative. And again, using the axiom of an antipode, what I get? I get S. So this is S, and again, this is the unit. And similarly, you have that convolution product with F is the unit, and convolution product with G is a unit. And thus F is the inverse of the multiplication for the convolution product, and so it's equal to G. F and G are both inverse of M for the convolution product, and so they are equal. So we have shown multiplicativity of the anti-multiplicativity of the antipode. The other properties are shown similarly. Okay. Now, what gives the antipode on representation? So if I have, if M is, so I pick of algebra A, so if M is an A module, then you can show that the dual, linear dual of M, that is a K-linear map from A to K, is again an A module with action. Defined by, so if I take A in A and F a form on M, I want to define AF a form on M. And so to define a linear form, I define their value on elements. So AF on M is just F of S of AM. And here M is in. So you can verify easily using the anti-multiplicity of the antipodes that it is an action. It is clear. And an important thing is that, okay, we have an action of the dual, but this action is not any action, but it makes the evaluation A-linear. And the evaluation of M, which is this A-linear form, F of M, is A-linear. So maybe quickly, how do I verify that this is A-linear? So if I take A in A, F in the dual of M, and M in M, so the evaluation of A, by definition, what is it? See, I denote delta, the image of the coproduct at A by the sum on bi tensor ci. By definition, on the action of a tensor product of a module, what is it? It is the evaluation of M of the sum of I. So evaluation is linear, so the sum, I can take it out, the sum and I of bif im. So this is the sum from I from bif evaluated at cim. So by definition of the action on f m stars, it is the sum on I of f of sbi cim. F is linear, so the sum of si sbi cim. Now, what is the sum of I of sbi ci? By definition, it is m S tensor identity of delta of A is just epsilon A1. And so it's F of epsilon A1 M is just epsilon A F of M. But epsilon A is the action of A on K. And so it is epsilon A variation of n of f tensor m. This proves that the evaluation becomes a linear if you use the action of the dual given by the antipode. And this is a very important property of algebras. Duals are a linear in a way that evaluation. Duals are A-modules in a way that evaluation are A-linear. Okay, so next time we will view examples, and especially the quantum enveloping algebra of the Lie algebra SL2, which is a deformation of the enveloping algebra of SL2, which gives solution of the Young-Baxter solution giving the Jones polynomial. So we will see this next time.